give up. They learned about it. And guess what? And what they learned, they passed it on.
Yeah.
Now many of us are real proud alumni of HBCU.
Yeah.
Historically.
Yeah.
Black colleges.
Yeah.
Watch and that. University.
Yeah.
Oh, bless his name.
Bless
up. So folk were forced into an action plan.
Yeah.
Because of their struggles. Because of what they went through.
Yeah.
Because of the fire. Persecution.
Yeah.
They had to come up with an action plan.
Yeah.
You want heavy as hell?
Yeah. Watch out now.
All right. Come here. Babies. You see, there's this railroad that goes underground.
Yeah.
Now you have to be quiet. You can't say nothing. I know you're excited to be free.
Yeah.
But while we're traveling,
watch out, preach.
Can you be quiet?
Yeah. All right.
Do you know when
yeah.
to be quiet?
Yeah.
Or do you talk too much?
Yeah.
And you never.
Yeah.
Y'all finish it.
Yeah.
Number two, midnights not only force us into an action plan, but midnights will deepen our faith.
Yeah.
Paul and Silas were forced into an action plan because they were locked in prison.
Yeah.
You can't just sit in prison and not do nothing.
Watch out. Watch out.
I mean, you have all the time in the world to think.
Yeah.
You have all the time in the world to think. You have all the time in the world to pray. You have all the time in the world to call on the Lord.
Yeah.
You have all the time in the world to get saved because you ain't got nothing to do but lift weights and look outside.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Go in and sit and come out looking like a bro roller.
Oh.
I didn't go with me. He definitely, I got to go myself. And so, tell them all word about nobody. He ain't driving around here. Y'all better have my way. Watch this. And so, watch this. They were forced to explain. They're locked up. They didn't do nothing wrong. All they're doing is ministering, is sharing, spreading the news. Give me 5 minutes. Watch this. And so, secondly, midnights will deepen our faith. Your faith cannot be dependent or deepened, rather, in foul weather.
Yeah.
You see, foul weather Christians are just like chameleons.
Yeah.
They conform to every environment that they find themselves in. Come on, man.
Yeah.
Sometimes you have to stand flat-footed and say, no, I'm not going to be moving this time. Say, you thought you could steal the daughter, but I'm going to stand right here. Say, I'm going to fall on my own sin, I'm going to lose my own mind, but he's standing right here. And that's when Satan gets mad and he goes to somebody else. Because you serve Satan in the boat of his own medicine. And he cannot stand it. Do I have anybody to look at that? And sometimes you have to look at that look straight in the face. And say, no weapon that's on the next beat shall prosper. Bishop Wilson Walker shares that God has to intentionally test our faith to authenticate our testimony.
All right.
Yeah, y'all know what we're saying, man.
Yeah.
We got to play. He says that God has to intentionally test our faith to authenticate our testimony.
Yeah.
He paints the picture of the difference between real gold and fake gold. Real gold and fake gold look just as good. They both shine, they both glisten, they both glow. But one you can put in the rain, and other you cannot. And that's why I'm looking at the gold in the building. And I'm wondering why you looking at me. And I'm looking at you.
Put that finger up on the shoulder.
Come on, now. You live around your neck proud. And before you left our house, you made sure it wasn't on in there. Because you knew that the moment that faith girl got tested, you couldn't trust it no more. Come on, help me. Isn't that just like folk?
Once more.